Good morning, children. Today, we are going to do a little help. Of course, you all know this lesson very well. We call this reported speech. What is it? Reported speech. You can call this as the direct speech and the indirect speech. What is it? Direct and indirect speech. Okay? Right. Now, we are ready with Milan. Now, listen to Milan. Here, Milan comes.
I am hungry now.
Once again, Milan.
I am hungry now.
Okay, Milan. Now, you all heard what Milan said. What did he say? I am hungry now. What is it? I am hungry now. These are the actual words of the speaker. Exact words of the speaker. So we call this the direct speech. We call this the direct speech. Right? Now this is one way that we give our ideas. So we have to say what Milan said using our own words or our ideas, right? So we call that indirect speech. Right? So we call it indirect speech. Milan said that he was hungry then. Milan said that he was hungry then. We call it indirect speech. Right? This is exact words of the speaker, what Milan said. Now this is the idea given by the speaker. Speaker is Milan. Me Milan kiyapu vidiya tamai metana thiyenne. Me kutiya ogala singala walata igena gannawa. අපි මේ direct speech, indirect speech කියන එක ඔයගොල්ලෝ ප්‍රකෘති කතනයයි වක්‍ර කතනයයි කියලා. මේ අපි ඒ මිලාන් කියපු වචන ටික එයාගේ වචනෙම කියන එක. මේ තියෙන්නේ මිලාන්ගේ අදහස මිලාන් කියපු දේ අපි ඉදිරිපත් කරන ආකාරය. So you all can think that you all can see and think well there are some changes. Right? There are some changes in these two sentences. Okay? Right. Now look here. Milan said, I am hungry now. Milan said, I am hungry now. That is the direct speech. We say Milan is the speaker, said is the reporting verb, and I am hungry now is the exact words of the speaker or the reporter. Okay? මෙතන තියෙන්නේ Milan තමයි මේ ප්‍රකාශය කරන්නේ මේ Milan ප්‍රකාශය කරන ආකාරය. Now here in the second sentence Milan said that he was hungry then. That he was hungry then. So here you can see some changes in the first sentence and the second sentence. Right? So now know the differences in the above pair of sentences. What are they? The first sentence, Milan said, I am hungry now. The second sentence, Milan said that he was hungry then. Right? Now note, keep a note here. Milan said that. Here also, Milan said. And after that, it is compulsory when you turn the direct speech into indirect, the verb should be there, that. Right? Now keep eye on this. Here you have a comma. But now look here, the indirect speech, you don't find that comma. So we omit it. And once again, look here. Here you can see the inverted commas. But here, you don't find them. So now, we have noted three changes, differences. What are they? That we added, we omitted the comma after the reporting verb, and the inverted commas, the opening inverted commas, you don't find here, right? And even there, at the end of the sentence, you don't find the closing inverted commas. No inverted commas in the second sentence. So the first difference is we add that. The second difference is we omit the comma. And the third one is we omit the inverted commas. And also, you can see I has become he here. Right, so you can note that the pronoun also changed. The pronoun changed. Here we go once again. We added that. We omitted comma. We omitted inverted commas. And we changed the pronoun I into he. Right, after that, I am hungry. And here, look here, we say he was hungry. And there is also another change, that is the tense has changed. I am, it has become was here. It means I am present tense, and here was means the past tense. Once again, note the differences. We added that, we omitted comma, we omitted inverted commas, and we have changed the pronoun, and the other thing is we changed the tense, right? And then the last word, now, it has gone to them. So keep that in your mind, children. Now has become them. මේ direct speech එකේදී අපි indirect speech එකට ගන්නකොට කරන වෙනස්කම් ටික තමයි Q එක. මොනවාද? අපි we add that, no comma, no inverted commas, right? And here we go. Here you can see how these pronouns are changed. How the pronouns are changed. And here, how the tense, the tenses change, right? It has given in two charts. Right, okay. We'll go to the pronoun changes. The direct speech, I, it changes to he and she in the indirect speech. And my, his and her. Me, his, him and her. You, I, we, your, my, our. We use you also as the object. So it goes me and us. When we take we, it is we and they. Our, their, us, them. So these are the pronoun changes. I think you have a clear idea. Right? Okay. Let's move on to tense changes. Okay, make mudalata mataka thiyaganna me karana tikama. Otherwise, you can write the correct sentence in the indirect speech. Meetika mataka thiyagatte naththam by this naththam me vakya liyana eka waradi. Mekedi dan obalan dakwa udaharanedi I am hungry now. E udaharanedi api tense ekak change karagatta oy vidiyata he was hungry kiyala. Balaganna balanna is, am, our, was, menama, are, were, e and is, it. That is simple present tense. And we move on to present continuous. You know, if it is continuous, the verb should add ing. And as it is present, singular, we use is. And for plurals, we use are. She is eating, we are eating, like that. When it goes to indirect, it is was eating and were eating. That change, you have to do it here. Verb ekata ekata eka hada ganna. Then me pronoun ekak metena wenas wenawa wage. මෙතන verb එක මේ යෙදෙන එක ආකාර අනුව ඔයගලන් එක හදාගන්න ඕනේ. Okay, next. Present perfect goes to past perfect. You know when it is a perfect tense, you have to add has for the singulars, have for the plurals. And you have to write or you have to use the past participle. When it is in the perfect tense. So it goes to past perfect. It is had in and both. No differences between singular and plural in the past perfect. Both are had and the past participle. Okay children. Ang hindi na may gugulan na tayo na natin kaya na. At na. Right. And keep this in your mind, children. Well, I told you present perfect goes to past perfect. Likewise, the past tense also goes to past perfect. When we write the past tense sentences in the direct speech, we have to use the indirect speech past perfect. Okay? Got it? Right, good. Then, past continuous and it goes to past perfect continuous. Past continuous goes to past perfect continuous. Right? So, like the present continuous, past perfect continuous also, you have to write the verb with the ing form. And for the singular sentences, we use was, and for the plural sentences, we use verb. Was eating and were eating. Right? Okay, I told you it goes with changes. Past perfect continuous. Keep this in your mind, children. It is past. So, you have to take the word had as it is perfect tense. And I told you at the very first beginning when I am talking about the perfect tenses, I told you that the past participle should be there. So we add been here. Been. When we use the perfect tenses, and you know it is continuous, so we write the verb with the ing form. So once again, we don't find a difference between the singular plural. It is had been eaten, whether it is a singular sentence or a plural sentence, both you have to use had been and the verb with the ing form. I think you got it. Past simple present. You can present now. Then what idea can you have a change when name is a change when name past tense. Past change. Simple present, simple past. Simple present, simple past. Present continuous, past continuous. Always the present goes to past. Present continuous, past continuous. Present perfect, past perfect. Present perfect, past perfect. And look here. I told you present goes to past. Like that. Wise. Past of all the past tenses, it moves to perfect tenses. Perfect order. Past perfect. Had past tense we use past perfect. And past continuous we use past perfect continuous. Got it? I think you have an idea about this now. Now, let's move on to future forms. May present, past, again, ilangada apita wenasena de tama atita ka, but anagatha kale. Vartamana kale, anagatha kale wage ma apita wenasena deka anagatha kale. Vartamana, atita, anagatha. Past, present, past, future. Will, it is good. Yes, now you all read shall, would. Don't write shall, should. Will and shall both would. Once again, children, will and shall both would. No should there. Ethana should kiya yani naya. Okay? Can, could, may, might. Can, could, may, might. I can dance, he could dance. Right? Got it? Like that. Okay? Next. This is very important. These changes also we find in the indirect speech. Right? When you move on to indirect speech, these changes also must keep in your mind very well. Right? If it is a general truth, the general truth එකක් කියන්නේ ඔයාටවත් මටවත් වෙනස් කරන්න පුළුවන් දෙයක් නෙවෙයි. අපිට ඉර බඩගිරින් පායනවා කියලා කියන්න බෑනේ. අනේ ඒ වගේ ඒක general truth එකක්. ඒක අපිට වෙනස් කළ හැකි දෙයක් නෙවෙයි. ඒ වගේ දේවල් වලදී අපි no tense changes. අපි ඒ වගේ වාක්‍යයක් ලියනකොට tense එක මේ ආකාරයට වෙනස් කරගන්නේ නැහැ. right? For example, our teacher said the sun sets in the west. The sun sets in the west, right? அப்படி இருக்கேன் வேணி, the sun sets in the north hari, east hari, south hari இருக்கேன் வேணி, இக்க வினாஸ்லின் நேம் நேதிதியா. இத்தக்கொட்டு, our teacher said that the sun sets in the west. Our teacher said that the sun sets in the west. Okay? No tense changes. Okay? Got it? Right. Now, look here. Now, I told you this is the reporting verb. Said. And Milan said. This is the reporting verb. This is the reporter and this is the reporting verb. Right? And if the reporting verb here we said said past reporting verb is the said and it is in the past. Now look here children, here the reporting verb it says says, it is says, it means it is in the present tense. It is in the present tense. So, Milan says, I am hungry. Milan says, I am hungry. Right? Keep this in your mind well. Reporting verb is in the present tense. Milan says, I am hungry. So, now look here. Milan says that he is hungry. Now you can see the difference. Yeah? Milan said, I am hungry. Milan said that he was hungry. But here, the reporting verb is in the present tense. So it is, Milan said that he is hungry. Right? Make a hundred matakatiya and put a bucket of pressure on the way of the middle reporting verb with a change color. Then, if again you have a general put the other way down with the end. That is on the day, right? Obelari matakata, yeah. Right? And the other thing here also, when you use would, should, ought, might, used to, could, must, no changes. The direct speech. I could, when it goes to indirect, she could. Our teacher said, I could do the task. So, then when you go to indirect speech, you have to say that she could do the task. Right? No changes. Right? And here we go once again. I told you we added that and no commas, no inverted commas. We have changed the pronouns and we have changed the tenses. But these are three important facts that you all have to keep it in your mind, keep them in your mind. General truth, no changes. Reporting verb is the reporting verb in the present tense. No tense changes. And if you use one of these words, no changes. Same word you have to write. Okay. I think you have got a good idea about the indirect and direct speech. මේක නෝකට පොඩි බයක් තියෙනවද පුතේ? මේ recorded speech එක කරන්න ගියාම පොඩි බයක් තියෙනවා. මේ මේ ටික ඔළුවේ හරියට නැති නිසා තමයි ඔයගලගේ බය ඇති කරගෙන තියෙන්නේ. But now I think you have a clear idea. මේ ටික හොඳට පාඩම් කරගත්තොත් විභාගයේදී ඔයගලට මේ විදිහට ප්‍රශ්නයක් දීලා තිබ්බොත් මේක compulsory question එක paper 2 එකට එන්නේ english paper එකේ part 2 එකට දෙන compulsory question එක many changes සමහර ලාවට මේ අවුරුද්දේ ඔයාලට ලැබෙන්නත් පුළුවන් නොලැබෙන්නත් පුළුවන් we can't predict අපිට ඒක ගැන කියන්න බෑ නමුත් direct indirect speech එකේ ප්‍රශ්නයක් බොහෝ අවස්ථාවලදී ඔයාලට දෙනවා right sometimes it comes as a dialogue or it gives you in speech bubbles and මේ වගේ speech bubbles ඇසේ දාලා එහෙම දෙනවා එහෙම නැත්නම් dialogue එකක් විදියට දෙනවා එහෙම නැත්නම් dialogue එක report කරන්න දෙනවා right okay so for that you have to have a clear idea about this way right I think you have got a clear idea now so I told you some changes to some words, right? So here the word now, and when it goes to the indirect speech, it has gone to then. I told you some word changes are there. Place and time expressions. Now. Now කියන එකට මේක වෙලාවක් දෙන්නන්නේ ඒක මේ දැන් කියන එක යනවා ඈතට it goes far now then this that these those here there ago before now then this these this that these those මේ ඔබ දැන් සාමාන්‍යයෙන් පාවිච්චි කරන්නේ this කියන එක ළඟට පෙන්නුවොත් this is a table කියලා පෙන්නුවොත් අපි ඈත තියෙන එකක් පෙන්නන්නේ that is a table කියලා. ඒ වගේ මේක මේ පොඩි පදින දෙකේ තුනේ දරන ඉගෙන ගන්න එකක් නේ. අපි ළඟ තියෙන එකක් පෙන්නනවා this කියලා. ඒ වගේ එක අපි ඈතට දානකොට ඒක දැන් direct speech කියන්නේ මේ දැන් කතා කරන දෙන්නේ. ඒක අපි පස්සේ කතා කරනවා කියන්නේ ඒක තමයි ඉහළ ගිහිල්ලා ඈතට ගිහින් කියන්නේ. තොර this කියන එක අපි that කියනවා and these are desks those are desks ඒක උන්ට මතක තියාගන්න ඒ concept එක ඒක තමයි මෙතන පාවිච්චි වෙන්නේ here there ago before right and today that day today that day tomorrow the next day or the following day tomorrow the next day or the following day yesterday the day before or the previous day the day before or the previous day like that next week it is the following week right last week it is the week before or the previous week previous pillar and මෙලෙම අපි කලින් ඒවට උදාහරණ මොකක් කියලාද previous දැන් මෙතන yesterday කියන්නේ කලින් දවසනේ ඒතර කලින් ඒවට මතක තියාගත්තා නම් yesterday කියලා කිව්වොත් එක දවසක් ගැන අපි කතා කරන්නේ එතකොට ඒකට previous day කියන්න පුළුවන් last week එහෙමද last year බලමුකෝ last week කියන එක previous week වෙනවා වගේ last year කියන එක මොකද වෙන්නේ පුතේ previous year හරිම ලේසි මේක හොඳ අයිඩියා එකක් ඔයගලන් ගන්නකොත් මේ direct speech indirect speech කියන එක or the reported speech කියන එක හරිම ලේසි අනිතන ඔයගලන් දැන් මේක ගොඩක් ලේසියට අවබෝධ වෙලා ඇති එන මේ changes ටික හොඳට මතක තියාගන්න we have to add that no commas no inverted commas change the pronoun change the tense changes to some words right okay and this is what I have done මේක මම කරපු ටික right So make up any kama kiyana na api samanyen katha karana sampadeyen siddha wen deyak mokada karanne api we add that no commas no inadequate commas we have to change the pronoun we have to change the tense and we have to do some changes to verbs understood right we add that no commas no inverted commas we change the pronoun we change the tense and the change we do some changes to verbs right got it right okay so these are the pronoun changes tense changes and the place and time expressions here I will give you a small activity
Rani says,
here. Look here. Prani is the speaker or the reporter. Reporting verb is in the present tense. Says, I am very happy. So, I told you no changes if the reporting verb is in the present tense. But, you have to change the pronoun. You are not Rani, right? So, you have to say she. Then, Mrs. Pereira said, I would like chocolate most. Mrs. Pereira said, I would like chocolate most, right? Here, I told you, if the word would, should, or to might, used to, could, or must, you can't change the verb. So, when you write it in the indirect speech, once again, you have to use the word would. And Mrs. Pereira, lady, you have to change the pronoun as she. Understood? Right. Okay? Right. Now here, this will help you a lot. Right? This will help you a lot. These are the questions you all have got for the last 5 years. Right? I'm going to make him a penama. Ugalanda, name Prashnaya, name Indi Prashnaya, Vibhaga Prashapatre, baby Kira. Right? 2008, it was test 10. And you can take the past papers and check all these questions. 2010, it was test 11. 2016, test 12. 2017, test 12. Now note this, even in 2016, the reported speech was there. 2017, the reported speech was there. And 18, you don't find. Once again, last year, 2019, it was test 10. We don't know what will happen to 2020, right? Anyway, it will move on to 2021, but it is the GCO level 2020. I hope you have learned and you have a clear idea about the reported speech. So I hope that you don't find any difficulty to write answers if you get a question in 2020. Okay, children? So I think you have a clear idea. I just do a small help. We did a small help to brush up or memorize or top up your grammatical knowledge or the knowledge what you are having about reported speech to a certain extent. Okay, children, hope you have a nice day.